Okay, so I'm Shakun, and the session that we are here today is, in this session, we'll talk about how you can add real-world visualizations to your Power BI dashboards using Visio. Just by call of hands, how many of you would know about Visio, have used Visio? Okay, everyone, almost a huge number, that's good to know. And how many of you have actually heard or used Visio Visual before? Okay, show of hands there. This side, Visio Visual. Okay, great. So so this is a good opportunity for me to actually introduce you to Visio Visual. Visio Visual was released last year at around the same time in July, so we have been in the market for around 1 year now. So before we get started and deep dive into the session, a brief introduction about me. I am Shakun Grover, and I am a PM on the Visio team. I've been working with this team for around 4 years now, and this has been the project, one of the most proud projects that I have worked on. So this will be the agenda for the next 20 minutes. We will talk about how Visio sits into the Microsoft 365 ecosystem. We'll talk about how we can actually derive unified insights from your dashboards. Then we will go through two demos where, firstly, I will show you how the Visio Visual can actually help you get unified insights, and then how we can create such reports. So firstly, we'll see the value of what Visio Visual brings to your reports, and then we'll actually go and learn how to create these reports. Okay, so how does Visio sit into the Microsoft 365 ecosystem? With Visio, you can create a lot of diagrams and collaborate on them, link them to data. So that's what Visio basically does. And now, how does it sit inside this ecosystem? There are a lot of apps in Microsoft 365 ecosystem with which Visio integrates. For example, Visio sits in the Power BI dashboards. From Visio, you can create your Word documentations. You can create your Azure network diagrams by using Azure specific shapes. Then going ahead, you can also do this where you have data in your Excel, and you can automatically generate Visio diagrams out of it. Then your Visio diagrams can be collaborated on, opened, and edited in Microsoft Teams as well, which is the collaboration tool that Microsoft has. You can use your Visio diagrams, especially, let's say, BPM and diagrams currently, and then export them to Flow, Microsoft Flow directly. You have your Visio diagram, and you have a very complex Visio diagram, and you want to create PowerPoint presentations for it. You can just go ahead, click a button, and create a PowerPoint presentation out of it. So these are some of the capabilities that you can achieve using Visio. Now, coming to the Visio Visual. Your current Power BI dashboards, if you've created a lot of reports, you would know would contain graphs, bar charts, pie charts. So they would help you track business insights like KPIs, or you can track goals, or you can do your analysis. Now, where does Visio come in there? In Visio, you can create visualization of networks. You can actually create process flows. You can visualize process flows. And you can, let's say, visualize this entire floor plan in Visio. So this is the real world context that probably we want to bring to Power BI dashboards. And so the amalgamation of the two apps now will give you unified dashboards, or will give you unified insights. So now with business insights as well as operational insights, you can achieve bigger goals. If there are any questions, just raise a hand, and I can take questions even in between. So here, I'd like to take a pause and take you to the demo to actually show how Visio Visual in Power BI looks like. So here I am using Microsoft Teams. In Microsoft Teams, I have a Power BI report which is already embedded, and within Power BI there's a Visio Visual. So I'll just talk you through the story that I want to bring forward here. So assume you are a healthcare provider who has this task of providing quality care to your patients in your hospital. So you have a floor plan here where the beds are organized and there are sections in the hospital. Now you can, to the left top, you can see that there are metrics that you want, as a healthcare provider, that you want to track. For your floor plan, you want to see where all the patients are having higher number of falls. So by a quick look at this report, you can actually see that the sections that are here, these two sections actually show orange and yellow, which actually means that the falls in this section are here. By falls, I mean patients are falling due to one or the other reason. Whereas the right section of the report shows that that everything is green there. So it's all good. Now, the reports are not only just visualizations, but they are also interactive. So let's say I want to focus deeper into one area. If you have used visuals in Power BI, you would know that visuals allow highlighting as well as filtering. So Visio Visual respects these interactions as well. Now let's say we have seen as a healthcare provider, we have seen that the one part of the hospital is seeing more falls, and I now want to trigger an action there. That's where, let's say, my report, assume it has a okay, so that's an internet problem, looks like it. Let us take a moment here and let it load. Okay, probably we can check another example there. Internet? Is it the internet? Is it the internet? As in, because this okay, so moving on to the next example, this is a report that was created by one of our partners, David Parker. So what this report shows you is that you can have multiple diagrams in your same report where, yes, please? I will go through the create demo. So the question for everyone is, how did I get the Visio into the Visio Visual into the Power BI report? So I will come to that in the create section. I'll cover that. So this second example shows that there can be multiple Visio diagrams embedded in the same report, and they can be synchronized with each other. So let's say you have an organization with a hierarchy that you want to represent. It's represented by an organization chart in Visio. You also have a floor plan where the seating arrangement of everyone is depicted in the form of a floor plan. So what I can do is, let's say I want to see where all my marketing folks are sitting and where in the hierarchy are they situated. So now you can actually go and highlight the area where the marketing team is situated. You can even drill down further, or maybe zoom into that area and look around which places are empty, which need to be occupied, or if you want to find people to actually reach out to them. So this is yet another example where two Visio visuals can actually interact with each other. So that was a brief demo that I showed to you. What actually Visio Visual can do is, you can get new perspectives on data with real-world visualizations. You can easily drill down into specific data elements through interactions like highlighting or filtering, which are basic Power BI interactions. Just to mention, editing Visio visuals requires a Visio online plan, whereas viewing, up till now, what I have done doesn't require any Visio visual plan. So Office 365 users can go ahead and actually view reports. So I will also share a link of the reports where we have hosted a few samples, which you can go and access. So viewing Visio visuals doesn't need any license. What we have also, up until now, what was done was released last year. What we have done after that is that we have enabled a few more capabilities. For example, Power BI allows you to create email subscriptions where at regular intervals you can actually get a snip of the report in your email. Power BI also allows you to create a PDF for your report or a PowerPoint export out of it. And now these features can also show you a snip of Visio Visual within the report. So you can go ahead and try these features. Yet another strong, powerful feature that we've enabled, and which I actually have already demoed, is the Microsoft Teams tab, where you can embed a Power BI report which already has a Visio Visual now. Visio Visual is available for all platforms of Power BI, which means that you can use or add Visio Visual to Power BI web, desktop, or your phone app. Moreover, your single sign-on works seamlessly for all of these apps. So you don't have to, so even though your Visio file will be hosted at a cloud location, a SharePoint location, you won't have to go and manually sign into your SharePoint account to actually access the Visio file and view it in your Power BI report. So now's where I will actually show how to add the Visio Visual to the reports. OK, so your current report has only charts. And this scenario shows you how you have a process where you want to track the actual and expected ticket SLA for a process. Let's assume it's a loan approval process. So you have two charts there where you have the expected and actual ticket SLA versus the lower chart, which shows you the resources assigned to each step in the process flow, in the flow that's there in the organization. Now, you would want to add a visual to it. So I've just moved the charts at the bottom so to make space for the visual. So the first time you open your report, you would not see your Visio Visual here. This section hosts only the core or the default visuals. So you go to the ellipsis menu or the more menu, which opens up the marketplace. Once into the marketplace, you search for Visio. It is also a Power BI certified visual, so you can even scroll to the certified section of Power BI and actually just find Visio there. No, it's already added, so probably it's not showing there. I've already added it. OK, you can easily find it here, I'm sure about it. Sorry? I'm not sure. So what I'm struggling with right now is the resolution, because of which I'm not able to close the window. OK, it's gone. Once you add it from the marketplace, you will see it in the visualizations pane here. So you can add it. Then to initialize any visual, we usually have to select one ID. So now this will get initiated. Further on, because I will need a Visio file which is hosted on SharePoint, so I will need the URL for that file. So I have a file which is created. This is the diagram of the process that I want to show inside Visio Visual. It's the loan approval process. So I go to the embed menu here, embed console. I copy the embed URL and go and paste it in this screen. So So in the interest of time, I will be skipping some steps, but you just go ahead, embed it, and it connects seamlessly and immediately. So once here we go to, so once the diagram is embedded, the next step that we have to do is your Visio file is made up of shapes and your data is made up of rows. Now we have to go and connect the two. So I will use a unique ID in your Power BI data to map with metadata of my shapes. So there's a kind of linking that will happen based on, and further on, once the linking happens, I will be able to apply overlays to it, overlays like text overlays or color overlays. So so if I select each of the shapes, I can actually go and map it manually. So if you notice here, the mapping happened automatically. The reason for it is in Visio, because all of you know Visio, in Visio, there's metadata, there's shape data. It has a field ID. Now that ID actually immediately mapped with one of the columns, which was process description there, and it automatically mapped. So there are two ways to map your data to your diagram. One is manual and one is automatic. So if you understand shape data fully, it is best to do an automatic mapping. Now, having done that, I now want to apply overlays to my diagram. So let's say I want to see the deviation for each of the steps. When I say deviation, the expected SLA might be more than the actual SLA or vice versa. I selected deviation for this particular diagram. Once done, you can go ahead and change the ranges here, the color ranges here, to be able to customize your visual. Skipping steps, going to the final output, where I have also applied text overlays. When I say text overlays, I want to see a lot of text as well in each of my with my diagram. If you see here, you can actually see actual ticket SLA, expected ticket SLA alongside the color. Now, this color means probably the actual ticket SLA is taking much longer than the expected ticket SLA, because of which it's highlighted as red. So as a corrective action, what would you do? You can actually go and select it. It will filter the report. Now you see that your SLAs are off. Your SLAs are off probably because your resources assigned to this step were not enough. So as a process owner, you would want to reorganize your resource allocation to the process. Any questions with the creation? And I'm happy to take them. OK, going further. So a summary of what we did, we created a Visio diagram, we imported into Power BI, we mapped the shapes based on shape data, then we defined all the interactions, we did highlight and we did filtering, and then in the end, you can go ahead and share your dashboard like any other Power BI dashboard. So as I promised earlier, there are a bunch of sample reports that we've hosted for all of these scenarios. There would be inventory management example, an example for organizational performance like the one we saw where we had an org chart, a fishbone diagram, a facility diagram where you have a floor plan, a business process modeling diagram like the one we saw in the create demo. So you can just go ahead and go to this link, aka.ms/visiopbi, where you will find at least 7 reports that are hosted for you to play around and interact with. So you can to get in touch with us, you can actually go to any of our social handles. And if you want a faster response, just go to tellvisio@microsoft.com. So you just drop us an email, and we'll get back to you. That's all I had. Thank you so much.